Hello friends, today we will see the basic introduction of Weka GUI chooser window. For using Weka, first you have to launch the Weka software. So click on all apps, Weka 3.8.4 and again click on Weka 3.8.4. You will see a Weka GUI chooser window. At the top, you can see there are three buttons, minimize, maximize and close. For simplicity, I will maximize this window. Now, at the bottom, you can see the long form of Weka, Waikato environment for knowledge analysis. If you observe, the word Weka is derived from the first letter of these words, that is W from Waikato, E from environment, K from knowledge and A from analysis. You can see the version of the software installed 3.8.4. The Weka software is developed in the University of Waikato at New Zealand. At the center, you can see the picture of bird. This is Weka bird, which is a native bird of New Zealand. You can also see the tooltip. Weka, a native bird of New Zealand. Now, at the right side of window, you have five buttons. Explorer, Experimenter, Knowledge Flow, Workbench and Simple CLI. In terms of Weka, these buttons are called as interfaces. So you can say Weka provides five different interfaces for solving your data mining problems or machine learning problems. In this lecture, we will just see what is the use of each interface. In detail, explanation of each interface will be covered in the next lectures. So, first we will see the Explorer interface. For viewing any interface, you have to just click on that interface. You can see Weka Explorer. There are different options which we will see later. The easiest way to use Weka is through graphical user interface called Explorer. This is environment for exploring data. By using menu selection and form filling, you can access all its facilities. For example, read dataset from file and build decision tree from it. The GUI of Explorer is very user-friendly. You are provided with the tooltip for each option. If you move mouse pointer to any option, you can see what is the use of that function. If I say pre-process, the tooltip is open, edit and save instance. If I go to open file, open a set of instances from a file. Explorer holds everything in the main memory. When you open dataset, it immediately loads all its data into main memory. Therefore, you can apply it to small and medium sized problems. Next interface is Experimenter. You can see there are three options: setup, run, analyze. Now, Experimenter interface is used to perform experiments. It is designed to help you to answer a basic practical questions, that is, when to apply classification, when to apply regression techniques, when to apply clustering, which method is best suited for the given data mining problem. which parameter values work best for the given values. Experimenter allows you to automate the process. You can run classifiers and filters with different parameter settings on datasets. With the help of Experimenter, you can collect performance statistics. You can also perform significance test. You can call algorithms through your Java code by using Java remote method invocation, that is Java RMI technique. Users can distribute computing load across multiple machines. With the help of Experimenter, you can set up large-scale statistical experiments and leave them to run. Next interface is Knowledge Flow. Knowledge Flow interface is somewhat like an Explorer interface. The working of Explorer interface and Knowledge Flow interface is basically same, but the difference is that Knowledge Flow interface has drag and drop interface. For example, at the left side you can see there are various options: data sources, data sinks, data generators. Whichever option you want, select and drag and drop, select and drag and drop, which is very easy. For large data sets, Knowledge Flow interface is preferred. If users are using incremental algorithms, then they also use the Knowledge Flow interface. With the help of Knowledge Flow interface, users can configure their processes. They can connect different components representing data sources, pre-processing tools, learning algorithms, evaluation methods, and visualization modules. If filters and learning algorithms are capable of incremental learning, then data can be loaded and processed incrementally. Now, the next interface is Workbench. We will see Workbench later. First, we will see the next interface, Simple CLI. CLI stands for Command Line Interface. It is a simple command line interface which allows direct execution of Weka commands. You can see at the bottom there is a text box and you have to type your commands in this box. For example, I type help, so I will get some commands like cls, echo, exit, help, history, and many more. User has to use these commands and run their problem. Next interface is Workbench. Now, what is Workbench? It is unified graphical user interface. If you see, it is combined with the help of all other interfaces, that is Explorer, next Knowledge Flow, Experimenter, and Simple CLI. You can see pre-process, which was from Explorer, here Experiment, from Experimenter, data mining processes means Knowledge Flow, and Simple CLI means command line interface. So all these interfaces are combined into one application. User can also install extra plugins which they need. That new plugin can also be combined with the other three interfaces. Workbench is highly configurable. In if user can make settings before solving data mining problem, they can do it with the workbench interface. All the facilities are provided in Weka Workbench. What is the problem? Which technique user needs? According to that, interface is selected. This is some basic information of all these interfaces. The detailed explanation of each of the interfaces will be covered in the next video lecture. So, if you like this video, please press like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos on Weka. Thank you very much.